Well, good morning. It's 6:17 a.m. And I just thought I'd let you hear our little bird sanctuary out there. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Well, hello. This is Thursday. I want to let you know that I did not forget about you. Hi, I'm Lisa Fry, the Catholic unschooler. I really didn't have anything interesting going on today. This morning was very, very, very laid back for me. So I just want to let you know I was very relaxed. I wanted to chill out, and now I'm back. So we are going to the skate park, the indoor skate park, because my son, he loves to scoot. And if you don't know what that is, you can look at my other videos. I hope all is well, and I'd like to make this video for one of my subscribers, Trevor. Thank you very much for your encouraging words to me. It was actually at the right moment, so thank you.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death, amen.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world, for the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world.
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, amen.
I'm finding it hard to believe we're in heaven.
Everybody!
Darling son, we're making memories for eternity.
I'm going to try to do this, my darling son, without crying. You bring so much joy to me. God knew exactly what he was doing to send you to me. You lighten up my life. You brighten up my days. That beautiful face I will hold in my heart for all eternity. Thank you, God.
This is Brian Adams.
I like the original.
This is for all my viewers. Anybody that wants to be a saint, come on.
All that I want when you're lying here in my arms.
That's God talking to us.
Hard to believe we're in heaven.
That's what we're going to say when we get there.
Woo!
Woo!
Welcome to our indoor skate park. It's quite a wonderful place. It's empty right now, but I love being here. At the same time, it's very difficult because I have to stay here for hours and hours and hours.
I am happy to see you all, and I hope that your day is going well. If it is, I'm happy for you. And if it isn't, I guess I could say I'm also happy for you. How is that possible? Because you get to enter into the sufferings of Christ. It is not an easy place to be. Although it is possible, God would never allow any one of us to go through a suffering that we could not handle. It hurts really bad. But you know what? I have a funny story. There was a time, I think about a year ago or so, where I was laying down in my room and I was suffering so tremendously about a situation. I had this huge cross, probably like this big, okay? And my son had made it for me. I have it hanging on my bedroom wall. And I took it off the wall to hold it because I needed to feel God with me. We're not only spirit, right? So where we're not only spirit, we're also physical. That's how God made us, right? So I held on to this cross to be close to God, as though you were going to hold on to your spouse or a loved one of some kind. So I remember feeling as though there was this pressure. It was the pressure of pain over my entire body. And it felt like, just imagine a big metal sheet laying right over me and compressing me down. And all of a sudden, it was awesome because I realized, like I've never realized before, I said, God, that's you, isn't it? It just dawned on me that was God. And he was not going to crush me. He was just pruning me. He was preparing me. He was holding me down with his hand. See? But he wasn't going to let it kill me. And that's what we have to remember. So if you're in that place right now, it's called the place of desolation. Okay? God is there, but it feels like he's not, because he wants your faith to increase. Okay? We have times of comfort and then we have times of desolation. He is in both of them, but the time of comfort, it feels like, yay, woohoo, you feel like you can conquer the world. And then the other times, he's still there, right? He's everywhere. He's with you. Okay? He's with us. But it's your job to find the joy through the suffering. He's not allowing you to feel his comfort. Okay? Because you can, when the great saints were being steamrolled over, they were singing. Okay? So you can find joy in suffering. It's finding his comfort. So you have to find it out. That's where you're going to grow, is when you know that you're being comforted in a very painful place, right? It's like the anesthesia in the dentist chair, right? So anyway, I'm going to go write my book. Yes, because I am writing a book. I'm writing two, maybe three or four, but definitely I almost have one done. I've written them before. I've lost them before. So I'm writing a book, and this one is, I'm taking you through my journey of unschooling. I know that my channel is about unschooling. However, you don't get to really see my children all the time because they don't always want to be recorded. I can only explain things to you sometimes, most of the time. But the other thing is, what else? So I am writing about it. So I'm writing about my in-depth, you know, experiences. So there's that. And then I think today I'm going to start again, the one that I lost, about marriage. Okay. So this is really good stuff. Really helpful, good stuff. You know, or maybe even people who want to be married. You know, what is marriage? There he is.
That's my boy over there. I love my little boy. My little big boy. Aww.
So now I'm sitting down, getting ready to type, as you can see. So I'm going to write my book while I'm here waiting. We might as well utilize and be functioning in life the best that we can, because when it's time for bed, you get to go to sleep for the night, right? And when you're dead, you can sleep for a very long time. So your body can anyway. Your soul will be awake forever. Your soul never rests. So here I am at my son's skate park, the indoor one. And I don't always get the opportunity in my house, whether it's I'm not motivated over there, I need peace and quiet of some sort. I have chosen that when I come here, even though I am very tempted to do other things instead of writing, I have to keep fighting myself and saying, no, Lisa, you need to write. Write for a very long time, and then you may do something else if you wish. But to stay prioritized in, you know what you have to do and where you're going to do things, right? So when I'm home, I will pay attention to more of my videos, of course my family first, and then when I am in certain locations, like, so I usually clean out my handbag when I visit my mother-in-law, so I save it for then. That way there you're not all over the place when you're in one place, if you know what I mean. And so I write when I'm here. All right, so I hope that helps you. I was once told that this vacuum car wash place was free. A free vacuum. How cool is that? You don't see that often. So, because we're going on a train ride with my friend and her sons, we don't want to scare them, so I'm cleaning out the van for free. Finally, the end of the day. I look forward to both the morning and the night. They both have beautiful times, and it was nice to spend the one-on-one time with my son in the car. I just love my children, right? Don't we love our children? Oh my goodness. And our pets. Miffy's over there, but he's in the dark, and you won't be able to see him. But he's a beautiful bun. Yes, he is. He's our beautiful baby rabbit. But I'm sorry, you're not a baby anymore. I know. You turned 2. That's a lot older. In rabbit years, he's an adult. Right, Miff? His name is Miffy. So, again, this video is in honor of a subscriber, Trevor, for encouraging me. God always is in perfect timing, you know? Trevor had sent me a message, and it was so encouraging, you know, and even though it was encouraging in that moment, you know, when you think about things later, you're like, I really was like amazed once again. God always amazes me that he reminded me of how I was feeling about a certain something. And then, so when Trevor left this beautiful message just out of nowhere, I was later reminded that, you know what, God is encouraging too, and he's always on time, and he's never late, always on time. We are never without, okay? We're never without help, all right, guys? So I am going to go. If you ever do want to email me for whatever reason, as long as you're kind, no horrifying things, please, thecatholicunschooler@gmail.com. And I'm also at Instagram at thecatholicunschooler, where you'll hear little 1-minute videos from me or lovely photos that I'll take of food. So anyway, I am doing so much better on my keto. I love it. Keto is a way of eating where you're keeping your blood sugars low at all times. So your body can be at rest. It doesn't have to be insulin resistant. It doesn't have to come down with unnecessary diseases. And you feel good. You're not on your mind all the time. And you can afford food because you're not eating it all the time. Anyway, I'm going to go. It is 10:15. Tomorrow is Friday. This weekend, we're going to have a nice busy weekend because my mother's going to be here. Gram from Gramola. That's what we call her around here. We are her people. And then my mother-in-law is coming over. I think I'm giving her a haircut. And so we're going to spend a beautiful day together with the family. Why? Because people need people. I always say that. So if you're not close with your family, try really hard to forgive, to forget, to move on. You know, a lot of times you might feel, you know, I know for me, I've had struggles in my, you know, life thinking, you know, oh, this one doesn't love me and that one doesn't love me. And you really got to constantly seek God. It's, you know, recognize that you're feeling sorry for yourself, and that's not what God calls us to do, you know. So just keep seeking Him out. And if you are close with your family, good for you. Go and be together with them, please, okay? We're creating memories for eternity here. That way when we get to heaven, we're going to look back and we're gonna talk about all these things, and we're going to smile and laugh. We were saying that on the way home, my son and I, that, you know, we're just going to be, there's not going to be any more pain, no more suffering, no more sorrow, no more crying and death, and we're going to be in constant bliss, really. All right, so good night, and I'll see you tomorrow. I don't know what we're doing. I'm probably going to clean up my car. I got to scrub it down just a little bit so I don't scare my girlfriend's kids on the train ride. Yeah, because they're really clean people. And, I mean, I'm clean, but I'm not really clean. I'm somewhere in the middle. You know, I don't really mind germs around me. It doesn't bother me. So that's the way it is. So that's what we'll be doing tomorrow. So I hope you have a good night. I'll sing you a song. How's that? My favorite good night song. Ready, Miffy? Here we go. Good night. Sleep tight. Pleasant dreams to you. Make a wish and a prayer that every dream come true. Until we meet again. Ready? Adios, au revoir, auf Wiedersehen. I bet you don't know where that song's from. Do you remember? Come on, I'm 47. How old are you? Do you know these things? The Lawrence Welk Show. And remember that God is good all the time. Good night.
There he is. He stepped into the light and he's eating pellets off the floor. Miffy, what do I tell you? You're not supposed to eat off the floor. I have a dish over there for you. You don't eat off the floor, babes. Are you the best babe there ever was? Are you talking? All right, you say something to the subscribers, okay?
Yes, I just want to let you know that my Nana, she might be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
She might be wrong because she looked in her subscriptions and... What? Why are you looking at me like that? Okay. Well, I'll continue to talk, but I just want to let you know that she didn't see Trevor's name, so she's not sure. Why are you looking at me like that? Hello?
Hey, baby. Hi, honey. Honey bunny.
Anyway, I would like to tell you that...
Yeah, you have to look like you're talking. You're not doing it. Yeah. Here you go. Here you go. Oh, he'd rather have a nice pet.
Okay, so.
You're not going to talk anymore?
Yes. I'll do it through mental telepathy. That my Nana looked in her subscriber list and couldn't find Trevor's name, so she's not sure if he's a subscriber or just a viewer. So just want to let you all know that.
Okay, thanks, Miffy. Hey, gorgeous. Look at this. Look at this, babe. Oh. Are you all right? You're not mad at me, are you? You look mad. Are you okay? I think everybody should have a bun like this. Come here. Come here, baby. Come here, baby buns. I love you. I love you. Yes, I do. I love this baby. Oh, you're so cute. Okay.